Hi and welcome once more to the Norwegian forest. In today's episode, we're gonna explore wildlife out in Monadal, where you can see hawks, maybe golden eagles if you're really lucky, or some smaller birds really close up to the camera. At the end of the video, I give a short impression about the Tamron 150 to 600 in comparison to the Nikon 200 to 500. I hope you have fun with this video, I hope you enjoy it, and let's just jump right into it. Welcome to another video. It's not even 6 o'clock in the morning. We're going to a wildlife hide to see sparrowhawks and maybe an eagle. We're gonna meet the owner soon. I'm just really tired, but at least it's snowing and that's good. So we turned up before the sunset, before 6 o'clock. Leif Arne, the owner of the wildlife hide, brought us up to the hide and showed us around. He told us where we could set our cameras, there are different openings, high and low, and he showed us where we could focus our cameras and set the angle for the first animals to appear as soon as light was there. There was a deer laid out and a fox, both are roadkill, so born from an accident, you get at least some wildlife photography. I set up my Nikon Z6 with the Nikon 200 to 500. Beside that, I had the Nikon D7200 with the Tamron 150 to 600 to my right side. And in the lower opening, I had the D750 with the 72-200 Nikon lens. I didn't use the latter one that much. Most action happened in general over the day in front of my Z6 and the D7200. So my longer lenses, which was great. But it didn't just happen directly and we had a long time to wait in the hide. So during the early day and midday, there was not too much happening. Some magpies showed up and fed on the fox. Some jays came around and ate some of the bird food that was laid out. And it was just lovely to watch them. I especially like the jays because they are just really pretty birds if you get close up. Maybe a hide like this is a bit too comfortable, but we're talking about winter and snow outside, howling wind. So I can't really complain about having a nice day inside of the hide, not freezing to death. So for some hours there was not often something happening. Some of us, if not all of us, slept during the time, during the day, because we were just tired, because we were up so early. Normally one of us maybe stayed awake and could like wake up the others if something would happen. And it was a long day, more than 12 hours, trust me. But later, finally, something bigger appeared. Sadly, we didn't see the go shark pose on some wood. It really directly went for the food, which is natural behavior and I'm glad about, but I would have liked to see a stylish photo of the go shark sitting on a tree branch or something. But that's wildlife photography. You have to live with what you get. and I'm happy for the day. And I hope you enjoyed the day. So much about the wildlife hide in Marnardal. We weren't too lucky, didn't see golden eagles, but at least a goose hawk came across. And for my taste, this wildlife hide was maybe a bit too big and a bit too comfortable for the challenge of wildlife photography. But I will not complain because it was a funny day and a long day. Because we arrive in the dark and we leave in the dark, the owner doesn't want anyone to be there at daytime, which I can understand. Sometimes you get golden eagles, and also the hawks are really suspicious of human activity, and you should consider that, because it's easy to break the trust of these animals once, and then they might not come for a month or never come back. Always consider that. That's why I didn't really talk into something in the wildlife hide and make a commentary video about it. Also, there were other people and I didn't want to interrupt the scene. I just felt wrong about it. So that's why the video is like this, and not like the normal wildlife vlogs that I do. Then also, I must have admit, I really don't enjoy the sound of the shutter of DSLRs anymore. They make quite a noise, and I ask myself if that's maybe the reason why some of these birds, yeah, got scared. I'm really glad about the Z6. I don't get really completely out of the Z6 what I like you, what I'm used to with wildlife photography, because it's getting used to silent shutter and that stuff, but I enjoy the silent shutter a lot. It's an animal, bird lands, everyone else waits until they can take their shot. They wait until the animal eats and feels a bit more secure. I can already take photos, videos, no problem. No shutter sound, nothing, no mirror going up. So the Tamron 150-600, this thing, the old version, not too heavy, 1.8 kilograms, I think. And on the other hand, the Nikon 200-500, bit heavier, I think, nearly half a kilo, not completely sure on that. So why did I switch to Nikon 200-500 while I still own this one? I mean, this is a really practical lens, I really like it. It's easy to go around in harsh terrain if you're on a longer trip. It just gives you a good reach. It's not that light intensive, but okay, we know this is a compromise. So why did I get the Nikon 200-500? It's not a big secret. I wanted to change to a Nikon native lens for some time, but I didn't see the reasoning yet. Of course, this lens is sharper and this lens performs better in autofocus. My big problem was I got the Z6 in the beginning of this year, and this lens, the autofocus doesn't work. Not yet, didn't get an update. The newer version, the G2, got it. But this one doesn't have it. So I thought it's the best opportunity for me to change to the other lens, because I'm especially after the video and 4K compatibilities of the Z6. So that's my reasoning why I did the change. Always when you change gear, consider if it's really worth it. And I think it was a reasonable change. Now I can record video, crop in if I wanted to, and I'm just super happy with the functioning autofocus in video. So I really considered selling this one, and I still want to sell it. I wanted to get rid of it, this one, actually for some weeks already. But it was still there, so I took it on the trip. And I was really impressed. I mean, I took good photos with this one on the D750. For example, if you see my photo of the polar fox, or if you've seen the photos of the puffins that I made. So it works really fine, close distance, like most lenses do. And I normally didn't use this on the 7200, the crop sensor, where you get effectively 900 millimeters. I always used it when animals were really far away, when you saw my videos on Dovrefjell, for example, where the animals were really far away and it's really hard to get the focus. 900 millimeters is just not a comfortable distance. It didn't work that well, and the photos all turned out a bit blurry, not really sharp. And it makes perfect sense. But since I never used the lens on the crop sensor before, and close animals, I never really saw its capabilities. And on this trip, the action was mainly happening in front of this lens and the crop sensor camera. And the photos are just tack sharp. I'm really impressed. So I nearly thought, maybe you're not gonna sell it. Maybe keep it. But I doubt not that the Nikon 200-500 will perform as well. Of course, with the Nikon 200-500, you have a bit less reach, but also a bit more opportunity on your aperture. And the lens is just sharper and the autofocus works. So I don't regret the change and I really like both lenses, but I will go with the Nikon in the future. At the end of this video, I just want to say that I will not let the YouTube algorithm determine my creativity, because I think it's really not good on the content that I do sometimes, because I always try to get a video out each week. That's not gonna happen in the future. There will be maybe less videos, maybe every second week I will try, but this is a small channel, so we can just take our time and try to make better videos. On the other hand, you can help me out with the YouTube algorithm. You can like this video or subscribe to the channel. That helps out a great deal. I would appreciate it. I also appreciate a comment. And if you have anything to say while I'm not posting a video, there's a community section thing on the YouTube channel, or you can just post a comment on every other video. I will answer. We are gonna have a talk. I'll leave it with that. See you in the next video, hopefully soon, and bye.